The question of whether or not LGBT people can be people of faith, I think, is a kind of funny one, because they are people of faith. So it's like saying, can the grass be green? People of faith haven't always been welcoming to the LGBT community, and in fact, many times people of faith have been outright contemptuous of LGBT people. And one of the things I'm trying to do, at least in the Catholic Church, is to remind people that, you know, at least for Christians, Jesus' message was always one of inclusion and welcome. We have probably hundreds of thousands of LGBT Catholics who are participating in the lives of their parishes, and they're Catholic already, they're baptized already, and they have every right to be in the church as much as the Pope or their local bishop or me. Over and over again in the Gospels, Jesus is seen reaching out to people who feel like they're on the margins with a word of welcome. And I think what the Catholic Church needs to do is to really take that seriously and to look at who is on the margins today in our church and how can we reach out to them. I've gotten a lot of pushback for this book on LGBT Catholics, and it's astonished me how much hatred there is for LGBT people. The hatred for me actually just strengthens my resolve to advocate for them because it shows me, you know, again, what they have to deal with. And, you know, anytime you stand up for a marginalized group of people, you're going to get some pushback. It's inevitable. It shouldn't bother you. By standing up for people who are marginalized in any way, you are doing exactly what Jesus did, and you're doing what Jesus asks us to do. You know, they treated Jesus this way, and, you know, why would we expect any different if we're going to stand up for LGBT people?